Warning. This audio recording contains real occult incantations that when played may result in one or more of the following. Dimensional tears. Internal bleeding. Unwanted portals being opened. Unwelcome entities being summoned. The compromising of your eternal soul. Damnation. Unplanned orgasm and or ejaculation. Demonic summoning. Demonic invitation. Demonic possession. Demonic calling. Newborn baby's feet disappearing. Hot flashes. Doors and windows opening and closing seemingly on their own accord. Allergies. Apparitions. Complications in your afterlife. Hauntings. Acid reflux. Heart conditions. Unidentifiable odors. Excess gas. Weight loss. Weight gain. Nightly visitations from unholy entities. Reversal of baptisms. Feelings of unreality. Excess drinking. Brain damage. Diarrhea. Loss of interest in church. Please proceed at your own risk. Thank you and enjoy.
I'm gonna have
Father.
I'm
David.
smooth as full master, the magic coyote. It has its axes, axes is positioned to cut the arms and legs of Cain. We will test it on a lesser demon to see if what we made works well. It was forged out of the hardest steel from the deepest pits in all of hell. When the Son of Man and God and Lion quest, the gold tree will be there. They will seek out Sargon, Moss, Old Isold, and foolishly make hold the spell. He will pull the sword from the statue's breast. He will send the head right through his chest. The prophecy will be complete. We can truly claim that his final feat was his own defeat.
Let's strap Dugalion to the rack and buttplug his face right back to the future, to the past. Because a time loop's meant to last, he'll be stuck in a hell. Now we're cooked up with a spell to make his head cursed and undead. We'll make it burn and turn it red, and it'll fly right through this portal. It's invincible and immortal. He's gonna go right back in time and fight himself. That's right, Dugalion's dead.
Why did you wait so long to make another album?
Look, I'm just trying to get as many streams as I can with this hit, okay?
Yeah, I get it. It's a new world out there.
But dude, I won't finish the LP album, so what the fuck else am I supposed to do?
Well, this album sucks so far.
I know.
My
microphone
has some shit.
Recording.
What?
Feeling so low, especially on Sundays. All the churches burned to the ground. God is never around. They used to be fun days. I look up into the sky for the answers, but all I see are flying necromancers. I hate to say it, but I think I might be getting depressed. Why are all the bad guys bad? Evil makes them so glad. And what's with their eyeballs? What's it like to live life undead or fly around as a head? It's all got me thinking. I try to think back before the world ended, and all the nice folks that I should have befriended. Sure makes me wish that I had made a little more of an effort to get to know people. They told us hell wasn't really a place, and then they saw it with their big dumb faces. We're fighting terrors, but it really takes a lot to be brave. But the power of prayer is a miracle.
about to wrap. What's happening here?
making eyes raped by primordial flame. We had heard the tales of the Statue of Eve. If only we had known what truly lay beneath. Antediluvian remains and Krypton's heavy with chains. We took them into and cavern subterranean flames. Our hearts grew fearful and the shepherds were tired. But somehow sick curiosity kept all that inspired. And so we moved on and cast our cautions aside, tracking deeper and further than any mortal has tried. The rock at these levels was a shade of blue-green, and it was far released, depicting creatures of sea. And we were no lower region, and it was not understood. And there were buildings and doors, what looked like petrified wood. Yes, a forest of stone, the trees of such great height. When we tried to climb the ceiling, there was not one in sight. Raise up my chalice, we drink into malice. The earth is the palace, the dark ones awaken. Fall from the fortress, their power enormous. They rise on their fortress, the world will be taken. Somehow I wandered off of the group. I began to panic, and as I tried to regroup, I saw a glowing light. It gave me such a fright, but I assumed it was the others and that I'd be alright. I walked onward and followed and never seemed to come nearer. And this phantom illusion never seemed to be clearer. I knew right then that I was certainly lost inside this evil realm into which I had crossed. I came upon what seemed to be a golden throne, and there beyond that lay a mortal bone. It held an ancient blade which behaved like a prism, reflecting ghostly light from some unseen mechanism. As I began to move forward, I found my path was blocked by a thing that nightmares could in no way concoct. It was a foul abomination, and with horror and scream, by then found I was awaking and hoped that this had been dreamed. Raise up my chalice, we drink ancient malice. The earth is their palace, the dark ones awaken. Fall from the fortress, their power enormous. They rise from their fortress, the world will be taken. This hellish thing was inside me. My soul was truly forsaken. I had a horrible power. I was myself but a beast. I was too planful and comely when all of hell was released. These were ancient gods, the rightful rulers of Earth. They had slumbered for eons. The time had come for rebirth. I ate the souls of my kin. I tore their bodies to shreds. I drank the blood of the slaughtered and scooped their brains from their heads.
Past time. is Toronto.
Yeah.